Guys, welcome back, and today we're going to be talking about all my fishing tackle that I use for pond fishing, creek fishing, and all that good stuff. So guys, let's just get into the video. So, let's go. First, to start off with it, we have the good old handy dandy mini tackle box. And what I put in this is like some swim baits. They're pretty good swim baits. Really haven't caught nothing on these, so I really couldn't call them really good. But we just have to go to ponds, lakes, you know, try them out. Here's a little spinner bait I have. I haven't tried it out yet, but it's pretty good action. But here's a crawfish. As you can see, those yums over there, that yum crawbug. I got a little weight on the hook right there. And it should work just like a real crawfish. Also, down in this corner, we have a little grub with a red eye. So that should actually work for small fish like bluegill and maybe some smallmouth bass. We just have to figure it out. We have some like size 3 hooks right here. Right fast. Crap. Some size 3 Texas rig hook. But that's pretty much it for this box. And also we have some shiners and everything in this right here. Like a little shiner, as I call them. Shine head, whatever. Kill them. And here's like a little thing. Here's like a scale remover. Just brush off the scales. And you measure fish like this. Probably the day I caught a fish bigger than this. So it's really not going to help. But this tool right here is to get the hook out. So, and there's my little stringer if I want to string up some bluegill and eat them after a while. But, guess what? I'm not fishing, so we're going to have to use that after a while, too. And here's some other mini swim baits I have. This one's actually more realistic than the others, but it is a clear-looking swim bait. I think I went to Walmart and got this for, like, 97 cents. It was really cheap. And I got some of these swim baits right here, some white ones and green ones. They was really cheap, too. It was, like, $1 for, like, 5 of them. I already lost one though. But this is pretty much it for this tackle box. Also, we have the lead weights or something like that. I don't even know if they're even real lead or not. But we're just gonna have to use those the next time we go fishing. So that's pretty much. Wait, here we go. We found another thing. We got like a lizards, worms. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. But let's go on to that tackle box right there. Guys, what we got in this thing right here is just some worms. Like, this is like a, I want to say a 12-inch, 13-inch worm. It's one of those big worms that you'll probably catch some bass on. And it's also got like a little mini series of it. It's a like a 6-inch worm. I'm pretty sure I'm going to catch some bass on this in the pond. And I got a little another worm. Here's some more lizards. Here's some more lizards, and here's a little shiny grub. I think that's actually going to work when we're out in the ponds, because that reflects light, shines, and I think it's pretty good because it's got a little lead head on it, and there's just some more big grubs in there. So that's pretty much it for this little box. So guys, what we have here is just some lizards and more lizards and some, hey, we got also got a crawfish. I didn't tell you, that's about a 4-inch crawfish and a bobber. And on this side, this is where we keep all the hooks from 8s to 1s. That's where it goes. But here's some swivels. If you know what a swivel is, comment down below. You know what a swivel is. Also, we have some like skirts for swim baits and so here's like a little tiny nasty thing I never use. And here's another grub. Use it for creek fishing most of the time. But I don't really keep nothing down here. I usually just put everything down in this bottom right here and it works out. So I'll show you how to get that stuff in the bottom. Here's what I tend on to do. I just get this, flip that. Crap, you can't really do it with one hand. But you kind of flip that up. You kind of get this. And just move it off the side, and you get this right here, and you just push that down there. I tell you, it locks in tight. I mean, tight, I tell you. Okay, see? It just locks in there, and then you put this in there, and then you just get your crawbugs And you stick them on the side right there. And they should work pretty good. So then you just shut this back. And then you just close this. And you see how kind of how the camera gets kind of blurry? I think it's going to focus. But it's not going to focus, so sorry about that. Okay, so here's what you do. Just get this. And you like use all your muscle mass or whatever you have. Whatever you have these days. But it's kind of finicky to get this thing on there. But there you go. You just do this, clamp it down, and you should be. Wait, it's not. Okay, there we go. And let's just close it on that side. Kind of hard to do it with one hand. But, okay. So that's how you put your crap in your tackle box. So, this tackle box is pretty heavy now. This tackle box is pretty big, too, for a person like me. But, this is a good review on what I have in my tackle box and what you should have in your tackle box. And also, you probably didn't notice that I didn't have my crankbait in there. Probably because I lost it at the last pond I went to. I'm very disappointed. But who cares? We'll go buy some new one at Walmart or somewhere. Bass Pro Shop. Who cares? But guys, don't forget to leave a like on this video. And guys, fish on.